Before we can simulate a Turing machine, we first have to represent it using a string. Notice that this represents an immediate challenge. Our universal Turing machine must use a fixed alphabet for its input and have a fixed number of states, but it must be able to simulate Turing machines with arbitrarily large alphabets and an arbitrary number of states. As we'll see, one solution is essentially to enumerate all the symbols and states and represent them in binary. There are lots of ways to do this. The way we're going to do it is a compromise of readability and efficiency.
So we'll let M be a Turing machine with states Q0 through Qn-1, and we'll let its tth alphabet be gamma A1 through AM. We'll define I and J so that 2 to the I is at least the number of states, and 2 to the J is at least the size of the tth alphabet. Then we can encode a state, QK, as the string QW, where W is the binary representation of K. For example, if the number of states is 6, then we would need I to be 3, and so we would encode Q3 as the string Q, and then 3 written out in binary, 0, 1, 1. By the way, we'll use the convention that Q followed by the binary representation of 0 is the initial state, Q followed by the binary representation of 1 is the accept state, and Q followed by the binary representation of 2 is the reject state. We encode symbols much in the same way as we encoded states. We'll use A followed by W, where W is the binary representation of this K to indicate the kth symbol. For example, if there are 10 different symbols, then we need 4 bits to represent them all. And we might encode A5, which could be any symbol, maybe it's a star. We would encode that as the string A followed by the binary representation of 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. Let's see an encoding for an example. This example decides whether the input consists of a number of zeros that is a power of 2. To encode the Turing machine as a whole, we really just need to encode the transition function. We'll start by considering this edge here. We're going from state 0, so I'll write that this way. We see the symbol 0, so I'll write the encoding for that, like so. And then we're going to state 3, so I'll write out that here. And then we need to write the dollar sign, so I'll write out the encoding for that, like so. And we're supposed to move to the right, so I'll write the R there. Remember that the order is input state, input symbol, output state, output symbol, and then direction. Next, let's do this blue transition here. We go from state 3, and we read a 0, so I encode that way, and then we're going to state 4, so I'll write the encoding for that with Q followed by the binary representation of 4, and we're supposed to write X, so I look up the encoding for X, that's A10, like so, and we want to move the head to the right, so I include an R here. So that's the convention we'll use to write out the transition function. It's just a sequence of these 5 tuples of this form: input state, input symbol, output state, output symbol, and then direction.